family, my sister had green thumb. Actually, I used to be known for killing cactuses. Hi, my name is Bahar, and I'm the co-founder of Mission to Organize. Over the time, I have come to love gardening. When I started gardening, it was actually to protect my cats from falling off from the old and unsecure balcony that I had. I started putting planters along the edge to create a protective border. When I started planting, I was so afraid. But my sister and so many other urban gardeners encouraged me and gave me so many tips along the way. Now, 7-8 years later, I am famous for creating pop-up forests on my balcony during summertime in Chicago. I'm so excited to talk about this topic with you today, so I can share the joy that gardening has brought into my life. Let's get us started. Living in a city means a limited amount of space for gardening. But no matter the space you have, you can still find some room to plant some greens. Today, our focus is on outdoor gardening, but you can still use all of these tips to create a green indoor space if you don't have any outdoor space available. As you can see, in this little corner of urban cityscape, we all have different spaces to work with and chose different ways of planting. You can attach planters or pots to your railing or use any vertical space available to hang baskets or attach pots to the wall. Also, using a multi-level pots holder can create much more space in a smaller area. I have been blessed by a talented friend who built me all this space for my planters. But no worries, you can do it yourself by buying the right pots or planters and use some tools to safely secure them. Now that you created a space, you need to decide what would you like to plant. I personally find planting veggies and herbs very rewarding. Nothing like walking out to my balcony and harvest some fresh veggies and herbs for cooking. I do love a colorful garden and I do love flowers, so I always mix and match flowers and herbs together. But some of my neighbors only plant greens and herbs and their outdoor space looks amazing. If you're a new gardener, choose herbs. They're easy to plant and also very useful. You can study the gardening zone of your area, how much sun or shade you get, and what is best to plant based on your outdoor condition. I learned this by experimenting year after year, but there are endless online resources that can help you with choosing your plants. Now that you studied and made your list, it's time to head to store to buy the supplies, such as pots, fertilizer, soil, gardening tools, and plants. Throughout the years, I have gathered most of the gardening tools that I need, but I always make the mistake of not making a list of the plants I need, and I do overbuy. To avoid this mistake, this year I grabbed my list before heading to the store, and also I kept reminding myself that everything will grow double in size. Now that you have everything that you need at home, you need to organize them into the categories, such as plants, type of plants, tools, and supplies. As for designing the pots, I always follow the advice of one amazing gardener, Wendy. She taught me the trick of filler, spiller, and thriller. Once I decide where everything to be planted, I leave them in order next to the planter where they need to be planted. You bet, as an organizer, I'm in love with order and symmetry. But gardening has taught me that I can let that perfection go a little. Nature is not symmetrical, but yet beautiful. When choosing landscaping and order of plants, don't be afraid to get creative and let the imperfection of a perfect nature shine through. I use the floor of my balcony to plant my planters. I cover the floor with a piece of tarp or cloth to avoid any dirt dropping on the balcony below. This also makes the cleanup much easier. But gardening on a floor can be hard on your back and your knees. So if you have any tall surfaces or a table, use those surfaces for your planting. I bring this table from the garden downstairs to plant my basket and pots. Now it's time to get to your comfortable gardening clothing, have your gardening tools handy, play some music, and have some water handy for hydration. When I started gardening, I was so worried if I was doing the right things. I was also obsessed with the details of gardening. My sister kept telling me, "Don't worry, you cannot mess up nature." As far as you do the basic care for the plants, they will grow, And it's such a joy when you see your plants are growing. First, if you are using the soil from the last gardening season, you want to add some new soil into it. Stir the soil really well. Then add the soil into your pot about 1/3 of the way up. Grab your plant, hold it from a stem, tip it upside down, and slowly drag it out of the pot. Put the plant inside the pot, and then add some fertilizer and soil. You do not want to put the fertilizer too close to the root. Once you fill up the pot all the way up to the first leaf of your stem, hold the stem from both sides, put your weight into it, and push down and pack the soil. The root does not like to be exposed, but also don't pack it too tight because it will restrict the growth. Now put your plant in the sun, water it, and watch it grow. Once you're done planting, it's time to clean up and put any extra supplies away. I always keep a watering can, some soil, fertilizer, some gardening tools, sticks, or anything that I need for harvesting or maintaining during the season under my benches. But if you don't have as much space, keep any necessary tools handy and store the rest of them away. Now that your gardening is done, it's time to create some ambience by adding some lights, candles, cushions, and some furniture scale to your space. Even if you have room for one chair, it's good to have it there so you can sit down and enjoy the fruit of your labor. The hard work is done. Now you just have to maintain your garden by watering, turning pots toward light, fertilizing, harvesting, adding soil to the washed out soil, and deadheading the flowers. But the best part of it all is that you get to share your creation with others. I remember when I was planting my first lavender plant, a butterfly just came and landed on it. It reminded me of the saying, "You plant your garden and the butterflies will come." Through the years, some of the happiest moments of this garden have been times that were shared with friends, family, pets, or even bees and butterflies. Many friends took a harvest of herbs home from my little urban garden. Many foods have been shared that were cooked using the produce from my balcony during the whole time. Gardening has taught me so many things. It has shown me patience, a feeling of accomplishment, creativity, and overall, it's my favorite way of meditation. As we mentioned, there are so many benefits and gifts that even the tiniest leaf that you plant and take care of can bring. I always love to talk to my plants, to touch them and make a connection with them. It gives me such a feeling of gratitude toward our planet and all of its magical creatures. Hopefully, this video can inspire you to create your own piece of heaven. Come join us on our social media and see how the Urban Gardens of M2O's team is doing this summer. Use the hashtag #OrganizeGarden to share your tips and tricks and show off your garden. We love to get inspired by you. Subscribe to M2O TV for all things organizing and happy gardening. Bye!